How's everyone doing today? Good? Good. I got a thumbs up over here. Thumbs up over here too? Okay. Kinda. We're in the middle here. So I wanted to talk to you guys about the difference between knowing about something and knowing something. Okay? Because we come here to also know about God, but we need to know God. And there's two different ways of that's a two different approaches. So to illustrate that, I thought maybe we could think about maybe a celebrity, maybe you guys that everybody knows, okay, that knows about. All right, so can you guys tell me who this is? Who is this? Can you say it louder? I don't know if everybody knows. Bluey, that's right. So you guys know about Bluey, right? Has anybody watched Bluey? Yes, we can. You've seen some episodes now. Okay. All right. So to some questions, if you know about Bluey, what's Bluey's favorite color? Blue. All right. So that's kind of easy. What's Bluey's sister's name? Bingo. That's right. What kind of animal is she?
Dog.
A dog. So what kind of dog? Does anybody know? Australian Blue Heeler, okay, yeah. What about, all right, so we can know a general things. What is she afraid of? Does anybody know what she's afraid of? What's her favorite food? No? Who does she go to when things are really, really in trouble? Those things we may not know too much because We know about Bluey, but we don't know her, right? We don't know her because we may see every episode, but we don't know every little thing about her, okay? And that's the same approach when we talk about God, when we may know about him, but there's a difference between knowing about him and then knowing him, okay? And then that it's a Hebrew word that I want you guys to learn today, okay? So I want you to repeat after me, yada.
Yada.
Yada. Not yada, 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 that's different. Yada, that means to know, like to intimately know. Let's see, Grace, do you know your mom's favorite color? Yellow, is that true? No, okay. No yada there. The yada yada. Yeah, that's useless information. But do you know what your mom loves to do for fun? Clean the house, right? No, that's what we think as kids, right? No. No, but there's a difference between knowing and then knowing God, okay? And Jeremiah, it talks about it as this, and this is what the Lord says to us. It says, "Let no smart man boast about his smarts. Let no strong man boast about his strength, and let no rich man boast about his riches." Okay? But let the one who boasts boast of this, that he understands and knows me, that I am Lord who exercises mercy, justice, and righteousness on earth. For I delight in these things, declares the Lord. Okay, so we need to know God, not just know about him. So how do we do that? How do we know God? Do you think we're going to know God if we only talk about him 1 hour a week on Sundays here at church? Will we know God then? Will we maybe know about him then? We won't know God then. What if we only pray or we talk to God when things are when we're in trouble or when we are about to eat a meal? Should we pray and talk to him more often throughout the day? Then we'll be able to know him more. What if we only memorize Bible verses that our teacher tells us to do? What if we don't open our Bibles until Sunday? Will we know God that way? No. This thing, it has to be a daily occurrence. Just like you spend time with your mom and dad every day, you're going to know them. The same with God. You have to spend every waking moment together with him. And then he will reveal to you about him. that you know him, you know his love, you know his mercy, you know his justice, and you know what he has called for you guys to do. Okay, so that's not an easy task. We like to do things quick in 15 minutes, but that's something that we have to do as adults too, is that we have to learn to know God and want to do that every day. Okay, just like we like to watch Bluey when it comes on, right? We need to have that love for God and know him. All right? Or tractors. Maybe we should have done that, right? Yeah. He said, all right, let's go to God in prayer and ask him to help us to know him more, better and better every day. Wonderful, merciful Father, we come before you this morning humbly admitting that too often we seek to know about you and not to know you for who you are and what kind of God you are. You are the creator of heaven and earth. Everything that we see around us, everything that we experience, everything that we come across is yours. You are sovereign. You are mighty. You are powerful. But then you have also called us to turn to you, that you seek for us to know you in a relationship. And we thank you, Lord, that you have created that ability through your son, Jesus Christ, that he is the bridge to that gap that's between us. And with the Spirit's power, we can know about you more and more every day. But we know that there's oftentimes the world distracts us, that we set our hearts to different things. Lord, we're praying this morning that you fix our eyes on Jesus. Because when we know Christ, we'll know the Father. And you have revealed yourself in the Word, Lord. And you revealed yourself to the body that's around us. So help us to gather together and not just talk about what we saw on TV last week, but let's talk about the things that God has done, that you know about him, and reveal that to friends around us. That we not be ashamed of the gospel, and that we proclaim that great name that is Jesus Christ. We pray this, Lord, in your son's precious name. And all God's kids say, amen. Amen. Ooh.